Hey, dear Aries, guess what? This one's for you, okay? This is Tarot Illumination. This is your June 2017 general reading. It's not lovey-dovey or anything. It's just big, wide, broad Aries for June. Aries, Aries, Aries. The pioneer, the warrior, the fighter, the conqueror, the go-getter, the make-it-happen person. The seeker, okay? Fearless and courageous. The defender, the fighter, the defender of those who can't defend themselves. The protector of those who can't protect themselves. Fearless warrior, love warrior, warrior of love. Thank you for gracing us. None of us would be here without you, okay? That's how I feel, okay? I don't care whether you're a young girl watching this or a studly, like, gym rat monster guy. Like you're a martial arts freak or you're like some, or if you're a very gentle caregiver or something. That Aries energy is unmistakable, okay? It leaks out no matter how you might try to avoid that, okay? It's raw, it's out there. So we're gonna deal with it for June, all right? Aries, we shuffled in advance, but we're shuffling right up to the last minute anyway, just so that you can witness the energy being cleared for you personally. Thank you very much. And we're just gonna dive in. There's not gonna be hardly any astrobabble going on here, okay? With Tarot Illumination, it's really stripped down, bare bones stuff. There's no reversals, okay? I don't do flyers, jumpers. There's no oracle cards. There's no, like doing it by the book stuff. This just comes out wild and free. Comes from my heart to your heart, okay? And we do what we can. And if it sounds like total nonsense to you, try reading your moon sign or your rising sign and see if that helps out, okay? You never know. We're a mixture of all sorts of energies, but typically Aries energy is unmistakable. All right? So we're going to go for it. All right, here we are. That's enough. Sorry. You know, sounds a little bit wussy. I'm a guy, but my whole world is flooded with angels, angel presence, angel energy, interns, big heavy duty, like famous name types that I never use names because I don't get it. Everything I have in my world is very visual, and I just live with it and I accept it, and it's about time that we do something with it. So I'm just trying to make the best use for you here, Aries. Like, here's what I can do for you, and we're just going to make the best of it, okay? All right, Aries, we are ready to roll. All right, excuse me. All right, we're just going to cut it up in a weird fat cut. Who expected that? Nobody, not even me. So here's the general vibe, all right? Here's where you're coming from, okay? We're not dicking around. Here's the ever-present now. Here's where things seem to be heading. Already by this point, we're heading into the unknown, and you know, Aries, what that means. You're facing the unknown, and anything can happen. Ultimate risk, ultimate joy, ultimate failure, ultimate success, ultimate loss. We don't know. So how are you going to move through into that energy effectively, as a warrior would do, for the best outcome for yourself and for everyone else who counts on you? All right? Then, advancing further, what has actually happened in the journey? What have you invoked? What have you brought upon yourself? What do the fates, let's call it, have in store for you? It's a combination of all of that, because at some level or other, you are fully complicit in your own evolution, all right? And in that understanding, what are your hopes and fears? Because they are essentially the same thing. So, and where would that lead you? Okay, dear Aries, we don't know. Now, I try to do this from the heart as much as I can, and so I try to set it out so it looks like a little heart, even though it really doesn't, but Bear with me. Do you see this? Watch. Do you get it? You see what I'm trying to do here? Okay. All right. Remember, this is a general reading. It could be anything. Houses, cars, romance, college debt, family, pets, health. We don't know. I don't know. So a lot of people like to know what's just like when you get up early in the morning, like first thing you do is like, what's going on out there, people? Like what's the weather like? Am I going to have to put on a jacket? Is it too cold? Is it too hot? Is it raining? Is it dry? What is it? It's the weather. So dear Aries, this is almost like your card, almost, okay? This is the Queen of Wands. This is the energy of carrying that, it's almost like Aries energy anyway, carrying that fire, that abundance, that passion, that inspiration, like Lindsay was the King of Wands, so to speak, which is very Aryan by nature. This is a softened down, sweetened version of it where it isn't all about the fighting and the winning. It's all about, like, what do you do with that energy? Because the Queen of Wands loves who she is, how she is, and how she got there, okay? And she doesn't mind, like, being an inspiration for others, sharing her abundance, her light, and her creativity, and her just spirit with others. It's almost like she loves being a shining example, okay? She gets off on it. She gets off on herself, all right? So if June kind of feels like that for you, Aries, then it's kind of like an indication to, like, go for it. Like, take full opportunity of what's happening for you in June, Aries. In other words, it's just like good stuff's lining up for you. We don't know what the reading's going to hold, but there's potential, okay? It's just like the universe has got your back. So how are we going to deal with it? What's the general vibe? All right. Hope. Hope, hope, hope. There is hope, dear Aries. I don't know what kind of shit you're facing, what kind of crap you've been having to deal with in your life, in your own evolution. It might have been staggering. It might have been overwhelming where you had to literally act like a warrior in one of those, like, I don't know, what's her name? What's that famous actress? Jennifer Lawrence, where you have to do this epic warrior woman thing, facing into the unknown, dealing with all the monsters and the demons that no one else can handle except you. And you do it. And in so doing, you bring hope to yourself and to others. Like, there is hope. It's just like Aries is carrying, you're carrying a lot of responsibility here, Aries. It's almost like, I don't want to burden you, but it feels to me like Aries, you have the responsibility now to bring hope to others, okay? Because there's, I have to tell you, honestly, damn, fuck, sorry. I didn't mean, sorry. You have to understand, dear Aries, there are a lot of people out there. Excuse me. Give me a moment. There are a lot of people out there who are really hurting, okay? And a lot of the times they don't know what to do, where to go. They don't know. They can't talk to their friends. They can't talk to their families. They can't even talk to their doctors. It's like not even their loving pets can understand. They can't triangulate to their children or their buddies, or they don't even, doesn't even make sense to go hang out at a club or a bar and talk to a stranger. They're totally freaking lost and they don't know where to go. And that's where you step in, Aries. That's where you say, like, excuse me, everybody, get out of the way. I'm going to sort this out. Where you bring light and love and hope to others where there is darkness, okay? I'm just, damn. Shit. Excuse me. So it's like you have a lot to live up to, Aries, okay? And this would not be happening unless you had the capacity and the ability to carry this energy of hope and inspiration. All right? All right? We're all looking to you, dear Aries, for like love and healing, bringing hope and love and healing into our lives. Someone has to do it. Someone has to step up. Someone has to step forward and be willing to take on that mantle, to wear that shield, carry that sword for others, and do what has to be done. Okay? So where are you coming from? Okay? And now you have the opportunity to do it. Okay? So in June, dear Aries, you now have the opportunity to rise up into the highest version of yourself that you didn't even know existed, all right? And it's almost like it's divinely ordained. This is a card of sacred opportunity, so don't screw it up, Aries, all right? This is your chance, so grab it. This is like when you get the cards of sacred opportunity coming into your life, it's almost like an insult to the angels if you don't accept, okay? I'm not trying to put too much pressure on you, Aries, but you understand the energy of war. You understand the energy of battle. You know what it's like to just do what you have to do, to get done what has to be done, and you take no prisoners. You don't second guess yourself. You don't say, well, excuse me, hold on, what does everyone else think? No, fuck it, you go for it, all right? All right, you make the decisions. You live from the truth, the absolute truth of your passions, of your inspiration. And in so doing, by accepting this mantle, by wearing this, carrying this, you become an inspiration to others, okay? In other words, you march forward. It's like facing into unimaginable challenges where everybody has to go and nobody wants to be in the front. And so guess what, Aries? That's what you have to do. You just have to just do it. That's because that's what Aries does. Someone has to do it. So it's just like, this is your time, Aries. This is your moment to take up your shield, take up your sword, take up the mantle, and move forward. All right? Whatever happens in the rest of the reading, doesn't matter. So at this moment in time, in the eternal present moment of now, going through June, given this monumental epic start to the month here, taking yourself very seriously and realizing that, oh my God, this is actually happening. Holy, this is a holy bleep moment. I maybe was not even expecting this, but now it's here. I have to deal with it. And in other words, you're being a very, very, very responsible Aries. You're not just charging around like a slasher, like in some kind of crazy like horror movie or something, and just destroying like zombies and every like, you know, no, that's not you. This is the energy of a very highly, highly responsible, capable, like guardian angel type energy, where the guardian angel energy is all about like doing whatever has to be done to protect the vulnerable, to protect the weak, protect those who can't protect themselves. And that is a serious, heavy responsibility, okay? It might involve anything, whatever has to be done. And in your present moment now, dear, dear Aries, it's almost like you gotta like get serious here. You gotta get real. You gotta evaluate and understand that this might be something that you have wished for, and that you have manifested perhaps unwittingly, and now you're seeing this situation manifest in your life. Okay, and it might have been seeds that were planted long ago, but it's actually starting to happen now. You might have wished for this kind of energy field to happen in your life, where you could be the ultimate Aries, and now it's starting to happen. And it's like, oh my God. Oh my God, this is actually happening. It's for real. It's starting to show. And people are going to start counting on me to deliver. I actually have to bring the home the bacon. I have to bring in the harvest, so to speak. I'm getting off track with all this firepower energy here. But this is more like a reality check. let's get down to earth here, Aries. The reality is that people count on you. People are counting on you. And you really need to take care of yourself and understand that this is real, okay? So it might be a lot of responsibility, but you're going to have to grow with it and move into it. Don't hurt yourself in the process. Like, I mean, in other words, sure, yeah, be the hope and light for others. Yeah, and grab this opportunity, but let's get real about it. How do we act as an effective Aries effectively, okay? And that can be more challenging. In other words, it's just like, whoopee, wow, I'm just all this awesome Aries defender, warrior, guardian angel type. But you just don't go around slashing at shadows and pretend demons and everybody who screams, help, help, help. You have to evaluate and understand every situation so that you don't just go randomly like trashing everything in sight that you think might need obliteration and justice, okay? So just be aware of how much power you have, how much responsibility you have in executing that power. Okay, a really, 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 really good high-level, high five-star guardian angel does not pull out the weapon or the gun unless absolutely necessary. The absolute last thing you want is war. If war is necessary, then that's what has to be done. But if there are other ways to resolve issues, then you explore those issues first. Moving forward, what's going on? Okay, this is the truth. This is the reality. This is how it is, and this is a reckoning, and it's about time. And it might be like an energy of like, now finally I'm coming into full authority as myself. In other words, if I am going to be this like classic high frequency, ultimate highest expression energy of Aries, then I better be damn sure I do it properly. And so I don't screw up, so I don't hurt myself. I don't hurt others, and others don't hurt me. Okay, that's how I'm feeling this energy here with the King of Swords. And be very, very, very careful about how you use the sword. It's a tremendous responsibility to have this much firepower, this much weaponry, this much ability to bring hope and inspiration to others through the energy of defend and protect. Okay. And however that pans out, this is very, very, very powerful healing energy here, Aries. So even though you might be not acting absolutely directly one-on face-to-face as a healer, you might be acting as like the guardian angel for healers, okay, in some way or another, bringing hope, inspiration that healing is possible for self and others, okay? It is possible, and you are going to administrate it and make sure that it happens, okay? According to the law. All right. The laws of the universe, not the laws of Aries, okay? The laws of love, okay? Universal love. So moving forward with this power and this momentum, how are we going to carry this energy responsibly? Okay. We're going to do it with, in a very, very like administrative manner. You're not just going to go charging around, okay? This is the Aries energy being dispensed in a very, very orderly, judicious manner, okay? So in other words, it's amplifying what I've been feeling already. You have to be extremely careful about how you exercise your energy, okay? Because it has consequences. You can't go around just being judge, jury, and executioner just because you've got the weapons and you can do that. And you can like, you could just obliterate anything that you don't like, right? You have to be very, very aware, okay? You don't just, it's not slash and burn behavior. It's not a zombie movie. It's very, 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 very high-level responsibility, administration of how justice is served, how truth is served, how the truth is defended and protected, okay? So that's a lot, again, a lot of responsibility on you, dear Aries, okay? I know you can handle it. Don't you worry. So moving forward, what does this draw to you? Okay. Whoa. It's like a serious reckoning, like, oh my God, maybe this is actually happening, and that I am going to have to be such a cold-hearted, ruthless administrator of the truth that I might not be very popular at points in time. I might end up delivering truths and messages in defending that which is right for myself and for others, and it might come across in ways that might feel very, very painful to others. However, it is just, it is according to the laws of the universe, according to how things actually play out, in the way they are, let's just say, the way they are supposed to play out. These cards, you have a lot of, like, let's say this is very fated energy here, very destined energy. It's a lot of responsibility on you, Aries, to carry this energy authentically without causing harm to others or to yourself. Except, however, moving forward, what you draw to you can be very challenging situations that include cutting away things and places and people from themselves and each other that is no longer serving them. And that's kind of sometimes what guardian angels have to do. Sometimes guardian angels have to protect the innocent from themselves. Sometimes there are people around us in our worlds that are so beautiful and fine and loving and innocent. It's just that they're very, very vulnerable to their own innocence. And sometimes in their own innocence, they can end up being hurt by others. And before that happens, it's almost like you have to step in there, and it's almost like do the surgical removal that's required before it happens accidentally and real pain happens. In other words, if you can act as a very, very, very responsible, like, guardian angel, it's like like stopping a kid from running across the street. Yes, you don't want to do that. You don't want to grab the kid and cause extreme pain on the kid by grabbing the shoulders and looking at them and screaming and say, don't ever do that again. But sometimes that is the appropriate thing to do, okay? And I don't mean to hurt you. It doesn't mean I don't love you and all that kind of energy. But sometimes the absolute raw truth has to be told, even if it means like a separation and like a moving on and a maturation and a growing up, cutting away from the past to allow the future to unfold. However painful that might be, it is Aries' job to do that. That's what a good guardian angel would do in order to help others evolve in their own evolution so that everyone can have a taste of hope and inspiration and eventually thank you and be grateful for being this Aries person that you are, even if you have to use the sword, so to speak, okay? But it does involve balance here. Okay, I feel obliged to call it out. It's a very strong reading. It's very, feels very, very specific to me as your reader. It is broad and it's general, but it's also very highly specific. It's actually in terms of energy. Again, see the male-female energy here. In other words, it isn't just all male-masculine firepower energy. It's also exercising that same energy as though you were a very loving, soft, caring, generous mother who happens to have awesome firepower and weapons when needed, okay? And that's what a lot of times good mothers do. They love all, they want everything to be gentle and sweet, but and they would like the male energy to take care of the male energy stuff. But a lot of times women have to do what men are not capable of doing or don't want to do. And the woman has to be strong. Whether you're a guy watching this or not, if you have to turn into that compassionate side of yourself, which says, I need to intervene here. I need to just call things out how they are in their absolute truth. And I'm sorry if the messages that I deliver are painful, but this is how it is, okay? So, and I'm doing this for your own protection, okay? So that's how I'm feeling that. Okay, that's what you're drawing to you. In other words, you're going to be seriously challenged, dear Aries, to live up to the highest vibration version of yourself, if that makes any sense. I hope I'm not hurting anybody's feelings here by saying this stuff, but that's what I'm feeling, okay? So you are going to be challenged, okay? It's a huge responsibility to be that guardian angel type energy. So what are your hopes and fears, okay, that you can actually honor the code, so to speak? In other words, let's say there is a code, the guardian angel code. If I am being awarded, and if I am going to carry the shield, if I am going to carry the sword, I am going to carry the weapons, and I am going to move forward in life in this world of being that Aries person, the highest frequency version of Aries, I have to honor the code. It's almost like honor the warrior code. Okay, and I'm hoping that I can do that to my highest level of integrity. And God help me if I don't. God fucking help me if I don't. I ask for forgiveness now, so to speak. Okay, so it's understandable. I feel like I'm rushing through. There's so much like rush energy with this reading for me. It's turning into a short reading, but I just feel like power on. So where is this all going? Okay, this is absolutely appropriate. This is what I feel for you, for June. It's absolutely appropriate that this is the energy that is infusing your life right now. And however like strong this energy might be, and however awkward or uncomfortable it might be to carry this much power, this much energy, and knowing that you have to move on with this, there's no going back. There's absolutely no going back, Aries. Okay? It's like a graduation here, receiving the highest level of expectation. In other words, you've been given being awarded and being given a badge of honor that you have to now carry. You have to live according to the code. And that bestows you with tremendous power and tremendous responsibility. So now you are charged with the responsibility of behaving and acting that way as that noble defender of the weak and the lost in such a way that you can give them hope and bring them light and potential and that they know that they are protected and loved and guided by you, okay? I gotta go. I gotta stop. Sorry. Bye. Damn. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to like do the overkill thing, Aries. It's just that there's really, really strong energy here, and I hope you can handle it. Hope I didn't put this out in such a way that you feel like I've burdened you with too much. But I think you can handle it. I know you can handle it, Aries, okay? Please reinterpret this however you want, all right? It's your life. It's your world, okay? But everybody, believe me, everybody's counting on you, including me, all right? So there you go. There you go, Aries. Have a great June. Sorry I got all messed up in that. I didn't mean to. All right, so anyway, bye. Bye.